everybody. Good morning. What's up? What's up? What's up? This is your faithful narrator, Deacon Django. And of course, we're back with another episode of The Devil's Advocates this morning. So, you know, hey, again, this is another blessed Tuesday for you guys to come in here and join us. And of course, you know, when you come on with us, you never know what you're going to get there. You never know what it's going to be. Every week is going to be something different, something wild, something crazy. So, you know, hey, you know, let's go ahead and try to get it. And I am waiting on my co-hosts that are always, I don't know, they're always late, right? What's going on? What's going on with them?
Schedule.
Yeah, you know, black folk, you know.
Good help is hard to find.
Oh, no, my folks. Nah, you know, I got to go and represent for my people. But I'm waiting on my co-host to get in, and we are getting started. And again, everyone, thank you this morning for joining us on The Devil's Advocates. And we're happy to have you here. And today, we have a very interesting topic that kind of jumped off at the scenes. And it was very, how can I say it? It was very interesting, to say the least, because we started out on a topic that was like 7 hours old. It was 7 hours old.
A topic that was seven hours old. Hot off the press.
It was hot. Well, it was old and cold. Put it like that. Yeah. It was old and cold. But when we got it started, when it jumped off in the evening, when everybody got off work, it jumped. It went from maybe 10, 15 comments to about 100 and something. And you know what? This morning, they're still going. It turned into a war of the sexes right there in the room.
Yeah. Those are always great.
Oh, yeah. Those are the great ones right there.
Yeah. Sometimes the ladies misunderstand.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna tell you something. I think the ladies might have been on point on this one. This is one of the times I had to go and sign on with the ladies on this one.
Well, what you got?
Okay. Well, this is what it was, and it was in essence, it was a post about cheating, and I always get those. Yeah, I know. I always get those people in there that want to bring up the cheating topics, the no good men topics.
See, the male bashers of the world.
Well, you know, hey, I mean, you know, there's some people going through. So, you know, hey, look, black folks got issues. So we got to deal with that, you know. And what this was, and this was a topic about, how can I say it? This was a topic about when a man cheats on a woman, they expect it to be okay. But when a woman cheats on a man, the man breaks all the way down.
You know what, man? I got an answer for that.
Really?
I'm trying to tell you.
Do you think that's true?
That's absolutely true. Absolutely true.
So let me understand this. What you're arguing is that men will cheat on women indiscriminately, but when a man, when a woman cheats on a man, he's just totally crushed and his world is...
It's more devastating.
You think it's more devastating?
I'm trying to tell you.
Huh.
Man.
Why is that?
The reason is men and women are different.
Okay.
Men are physical. That's just what it is. We're physical. Every man that gets with a woman, their wives, their girlfriends, whatever it is, whoever that woman is to him, it's something physical that made that man fall for. Whatever it is.
Really?
Maybe it's a body, maybe it's a smile, maybe it's a face. It's something on
a physical. Something physical. So we talking about soul ties here?
Yeah. Now, when a woman cheats, you got to tap into her mind. You got to tap into, they know if they want to hang out with you as soon as they meet you. Now, it's up to you to either talk your way out of it or talk your way in it. You understand?
Okay.
So, for a woman to cheat, that man, the man she cheated with, tapped into something that was more than physical. Now, it's exceptions to every rule. But, by and large, that man tapped into something, you know, a place that he got into a place that's not... open. A man is just physical. They didn't, you know. Man can still love his wife and still, you know.
Okay, well.
A woman, she's checked out emotionally if she gives herself physically.
Really? So let me ask you a question.
In most cases.
Now. Really?
Yeah.
So, well, then let me ask you a question. You say with men it's physical, with women it's emotional. So don't you think emotional is kind of more intensive than being in the physical?
That's what I'm talking about.
Well,
that's why a man is so devastated, because that means if your woman cheated on you, you're like, man, he tapped into a soul. He tapped into a place that he ain't supposed to touch. What are you doing?
He tapped into her soul. Oh, he tapped into her soul, all right. Well, he tapped into her soul. Yeah, he did.
I did that.
Okay, he tapped into her soul right there.
He was able to connect to a place that shouldn't be able to get connected to.
Really?
I mean, it's like that with a man too, but he tapped into a mind. See,
he tapped into a mind.
When you get in their mind.
But what if they ain't got their mind right?
Well, you know what, you set me up. I almost said,
yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get that.
Well, sometimes a lot of minds are harder to get right than others. But if you give somebody an opportunity, you know, with women, it might take some time.
Mm-hmm.
And she just waiting on hers to mess up so she can go ahead on and move.
Well, that's what the goat did. Anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
the man that doesn't do little things for their wives when they go to work, they got a guy that comes in and say, hey, how you doing today? You want me to? Let me get you a cup of coffee. Now, if I get her a cup of coffee every day for about 30 days, she feels like I'm invested.
Is that all it takes, is a cup of coffee?
Not necessarily a cup of coffee. it's not necessarily a cup of coffee.
We're going kind of cheap these days, though.
Not necessarily cheap. Women are more excited about time than a lot of other things. If you can prove to a woman that you're thinking about her when she's not there, whoo! You can prove it to us. If she gets to work and her favorite Frappuccino is in front of here, I was just thinking about you and I bought that for you. Listen, that's going to go way, way further than that $5 it costs for the coffee.
Well, I'm just curious about that.
Man,
you know, it just
with a man, you can just say, "Ooh, that's a nice tie. She owe me, boy. She owe me." You see it? You got some new shoes. She saw my shoes, boy. She saw it. And then it's over for us.
Well, see, here's the thing, and I'm waiting on my coat because you know we're going.
Oh yeah, it's going.
It's going down when my females come in here because.
Ooh.
It's always something.
But they're gonna agree. They know that's true. That you gotta tap into. You know, once you get there, it's hard to turn away. It's hard to turn back. It makes it easier for them. Because a man can talk themselves out of hanging out with a lady. Women can't talk themselves out of hanging out with men.
That's because men are shallow. I mean,
for whatever reason, that's the truth.
No, okay, well, hold on here. Here's the way I see it. And here's the thing. I think that at the end of the day, and somebody put this out, and this is where it really went south on the post.
Yeah, now
someone started talking about respect.
Well, see, respect is gone when you can still respect the person and do some things.
I mean, a guy made an argument, and here's the thing: I respect one of my homeboys. He in there, and he's very vocal. And he made this point out here that if a woman cheats on a man, she doesn't respect him. And I said, I don't think that's what it is. I think what it is she doesn't respect her relationship. And there are plenty of ways to prove that.
Now it's people that I don't like that I respect.
Right.
There's a lot of people that I hate to see coming, but I still respect them as who they are.
Right.
So yeah, that's a different thing.
Right. And also people get the line muddled between respect and fear.
Ooh, ooh. Cut them deep, Django.
Did I say something there to need to get us an offering plate?
Yeah.
And,
see, I'm about to pass the plate now.
Well, my goat getting ready to come up. And I don't know why the goat won't leave me alone. But anyway. But I think that at the end of the day, when we sit around here and we talk about these things, you know, I think here's the issue with it. And we talk about people saying that a man does that. Now, a good friend of mine, who normally comes in and does our Ask the Attorney segment, made a good point one time. He said, you have some women out here that want to be chased but don't want to be caught.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so when you look at it from that aspect, if you're saying that a woman is allowing another man to come into her space and take over where another man is not giving her time.
There you go.
Okay, then that woman has already made a conscious decision.
Not necessarily.
Well, okay. Well, let me ask you this: how can a man sit around here? Let me say this. Let me say I'm dating a woman. Yeah.
All right.
And I tell her I want some space.
Okay.
Now, when you tell me you want some space, well, I tell you, you know what, boo, I'm not ready for this. You're telling me that I don't have to. You don't have to wait on me. But you're also telling me you want some space to get your life together, figure out what you want to do, whatever. You know what I'm saying? So my thing is, if you're purposely creating space and a bridge between you and another person, then you're allowing yourself to give space for another person to come in.
That's right.
Okay. So you can't get mad when the devil rolls in.
I'm trying to tell you.
Because, see, I always tell people this.
Tell your girlfriend you need space to me.
Need space? How about the universe?
I'm going to buy a piece of chicken. You want a fish sandwich, baby? I got you.
You want a fish with cheese on it? Can we get the cheese on it?
Hey, the fish sandwich of your liking. And you know what's so important about a fish sandwich with me?
What?
When I told a girl that, listen, baby, if I buy you a fish sandwich, I mean it. Because I'm allergic to fish. That means that fish sandwich is just
so you're going to be like, you're going to be like Hitch. You're going to go and get the big swole face and the big allergic reaction.
That's exactly what happened.
No, it happened. Well, you're bad.
Hey, I don't want none of it. That's for you. Enjoy yourself.
So you won't eat no. So I don't have no problem if I offer you a fish sandwich. I know that's one lunch and I'm going to be cheap
that
on.
That will be safe.
So, you know, hey, Advocate, tell us what you think. I mean, I think, is it true that you think that it's about issues of respect? Do you think it's true that men take it a lot more harder than women do?
Men are sensitive.
I think it's more ego than anything else.
That too.
Men are creatures of ego. When our egos get crushed, that's a bad place to be. That's a bad place to be.
You ain't joking. It's hard when they break it down like that. They break you. They have you singing Lenny.
Who's that girl? I love you.
Let me tell you something. Lenny, I done got over so many listening to Lenny.
That's not a song to get over nobody.
Let me tell you something. Yes, it is.
What?
Because you see this? A lot of people don't know that. And David, you gonna get it right off. Lenny is the song to get over. Because think about all the crying he did for the song. When he went by the house, when he listened to the music, he was watching the TV, he knocked on the door, she wouldn't answer. All the things he did.
Boy.
By the end of the song, and then he said, "Then I met you, darling. You helped me."
But you know what? I'm going to start listening to
this.
I got to go listen to that again.
Well, yes, it does. And you helped me. Lenny started hollering.
He got us up here singing in here.
Lenny got to hollering and fell in love with that one just as fast. I'm going to love you, is what he said.
He said, "I'm going
to
love you."
Hey, he cried for 6.5 minutes, but when he got to 7, "Then I met you, darling." Woo. Hey, Lenny's my hero.
You know what?
I'm gonna have to listen to that song.
I'm gonna have to go and get the words printed out on that.
Wait, when you hear it again?
I thought that song was a serious man-law violation. I'm like, boy, you crying?
Now he cried. I cried till I couldn't cry no more. The music, the TV went off. Everything was going wrong for Lenny tonight. He got up the next day and met the new one. Everything he went back to singing.
Well, you know, it's like Lisa. He's all cried out. Yeah, you get to that point
when y'all cried out. When you gave, when what did R. Kelly tell him when you fed up?
Well, look, I tell people this, and, you know, let's just be 110 on this. You know, I think it's wrong in today's society. It's a perception that when women get hurt, it's okay for them to wallow and self-pity. But when a man get hurt, the man law rule is that we got to keep it moving.
You got to keep it moving. You're a man.
Yeah, because we supposed to be tougher skin.
That's right.
But, you know, it takes a lot of times for a man to get to a point that he's really to let himself be vulnerable to a point of really loving a woman.
That's right.
And when that happens, no, it's going to be some consequences and repercussions. I'm sorry. It's going to be some.
Ooh.
You know, so we're going to get. Oh, there you go. Go on, Dave. Put that on there. In fact, you know what? We're going to take us a break. We're going to come back in with that.
Woo.
Yeah, we're going to come back in with that.
Woo! You can hear it in his voice. Hear that pain? Woo!
Yeah, you know I love you.
He wasn't absolutely. That's why he had to stutter, because he met the new one.
There
that's why he stuttered it to me.
That's what I want. Folks, we going to take us a break. We going to come back in with this one, boy. That's a hard one right there, boy. You wrong. Dre, you just stand by. We going to get back with this.
All right.
Advocates, y'all come on and sound in on us today. We just going to take us a little break. We be back momentarily here at your infamous Devil's Advocates.
That's when he threw crying right there. That's when it's rough on you right there. Mm.
You know,
boy, look at this here.
One time things.
What did I get started up in here today?
I had to go to one of my friends and
I'm having a flashback.
I still love you, baby. I'm so sorry.
Boy, look at this.
Listen.
It seems that I call her on the phone and I just can't get her to answer.
What in the world did I get started up in here today?
Car parked in the driveway.
Went to the house, saw her car parked on the driveway.
I know you there.
And then I went home and
what?
I watched television until television went off.
I'm talking about ain't nothing but infomercials.
And then I played my records until I just didn't want to hear them anymore.
Boy, look at this right here.
And finally, I went to bed.
Folks, we are back.
Waking up.
We done messed around and turned this into an R&B oldie.
And the tears were running down
This is schooling right here. I wish my son was listening. Your son, don't you understand this?
You just ought to forget
about
it.
You know, them youngins, they don't understand about this. It was back in the day when music was music.
Maybe you've never been in love like I've been in love.
Maybe you never felt the things that
maybe
I felt.
You never felt the things that
I might have been heartburn.
But this is
not
my
angry
girlfriend. I said, you know, sometimes you get lonely.
Boy. Okay, we back, y'all. What in the world is going on here?
I just want you to skip to the part where things got all right for him.
He's all right. Yeah, it's going to be all right. Boy, it's going to be all
right. This is when you cry hard right here.
My show has been hijacked, folks, to the old school RV. We done did some Tony Doghouse, some quarter notes, some 50 yard line.
I'm trying to do the
some elevations up in here.
Oh, boy. Man.
That's that 4 a.m.
back to Hadley's.
That's right. Good. Yep, Hadley's. We done did some 4 a.m. in the Saturday morning, Sunday morning up in here. I'm like, wow. Well, folks, we are back.
Uh-oh, here it is.
Uh-oh.
And you smiled at me. Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen,
pretty smile. Yes,
now we have a female coming in to give us a female's perspective on this right here. My homegirl, baby hair, ass cat, Ann, has swung down off her pole. She's usually late. I'm going to charge her $5 one of these days. $5 from the fifth floor. Hello, Ash. How you doing, sweetie? You see what we playing today, though.
Morning.
You see what we doing this morning. We done turned the rhythm and blues, old school pimp and player.
I don't love you.
Okay.
All right. That's it.
Ash, I got to have you chime in on this one.
What's going on this morning?
Boy, look here.
What kind of foolishness and mayhem is out here in these streets?
Ash, look here, dog. Baby, here. Look here. We started on a post that was started by a person. It was 7 hours old until it jumped way off. And when I say it jumped way off, it jumped way off. And it was about the issue of when men cheat, women are expected to move on and keep it 100. You know, and men are expected, women to tolerate that. But when a woman cheat on a man,
oh, yeah, y'all lose your mind.
Okay, here we go.
It's the truth. I've seen men that have cheated on women for years, had 50, 60 different women, two or three different mistresses. And then the minute that woman goes out with a woman, y'all lose your mind.
Rat,
you want to tear
bananas
up that. You want to tear up the house. You want to blow up a building. You want to beat him up. Call the paramedics. Call their mama. Call their daddy. Post up flyers telling everybody that she's a member of the Jezebel family. Y'all.
The Jezebel family.
Y'all be wilding now, telling she the thought bot of the land. Y'all are
out. Wait a minute. We did thought bot last week.
Y'all are out of control. Man. And it's,
so wait a minute.
It's
hold
crazy.
On. So wait a minute. So you saying women don't do that?
For the most part,
women don't.
No. And I will say this: even though there are a few men that will stay with a woman after she cheats on him, it's highly unlikely, and it doesn't happen that often. Where you will find a lot of women, you know, there are a lot of women that accept it. They'll say, "Well, you know, if he respects me, then you know he'll just keep it out of my face, or he'll keep it a secret." There are a lot of women that accept it, and there are a lot of women that believe that every man cheats. Mm-hmm. So you need to prepare to be cheated on.
So that's the cost of doing business.
I don't believe that, but there are a lot of women that believe.
Okay, well, let me ask you a question, because this is where the post went south. When somebody said, and this was a guy said this, he said that women, if she respects a man, she won't cheat. And another young lady came in and said, I'm telling you, that's not true. She said, women, you have some women out here that will cheat on a man regardless of whether she respects him or not, because she doesn't respect herself and she doesn't respect the relationship. Okay, so
and you have some women too, because that man has disrespected the relationship so many times. So that's what I'm saying. She's right as far as this woman doesn't respect the relationship anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You got some people, they do vengeance cheating. They be like, I'm gonna just cheat. Cool. So you can see what it felt like when you did it to me.
Really?
And women know the man they're gonna cheat with.
Yeah, they know. There are women that will sit and plot, and they'll seek out, and they go say, hey, you know D. Woods, I see you and D kicking and something. Let me go and get over there and get up on D.
I tell you what.
When, this is the thing. Y'all would cheat with, like, random girls. Yeah, sometimes girls at the workplace. Yeah, sometimes your neighbor, whatever. But I guarantee, when a woman is sneaking and creeping, oh, baby, we going for blood. We coming to get you.
We going to
hit that one and
that's
tear,
why I heard
tear you up.
Y'all cut us deep.
We do. We cutting deep and wide.
See, we just have mistakes. I'm sorry, that ain't no mistake. I had a couple refreshments.
I ain't gonna do it no more.
You said he get a fist.
I thought she was looking like from the back. You
know, I tell you, we men know what that all smiles mean. Yeah, don't play with us.
See, you just admitted that y'all cut us. Do you know what?
I'm gonna put that out there. People can only take so much. Now, every woman is not a cheater. There are some women on the planet like me. We're just going to leave you alone. Oh, that's
Did
what you want to
that
do?
Like me.
That's right, like me. I don't cheat. I'm not a cheater. I've never cheated on anyone ever before in my life. Never. I've been cheated on, but I've never cheated on anyone.
Really?
Okay. I'll leave. I'm the type of girl.
No, that's what you should
now
do.
Now, look. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you I may not throw a chair at you or something before I leave.
I'm going to throw a chair.
I might flip a table over. No, that's back in the day. I've calmed down now. I don't do that before.
You'll calm down.
But back in the day, yes. You may have caught some other stuff, and people would be so shocked because I'm so much fun and so calm most of the time. And I would tell these dudes, I would say, do not cheat on me because I will fruit out on you. And nobody ever believes it because I'm like, ha ha ha, you know, cracking jokes all the time.
Don't believe it.
They don't believe me. And then when I do it, they're shocked.
That these streets is real with ass.
Yeah, these streets is real. Don't make me go to the other side. Don't make me do it. So, you know, so I'll remain calm. So since I've gotten older now, I don't fruit out like that because I'm more mature.
I just
leave you and I'll never talk to you again. It's a bunch of dudes. They know they ghosted. And then they'll try and come back months later because this thing with y'all men.
Mm-mm.
Y'all think if we just let some time go by,
man,
some reason in y'all head, y'all
girl
think
bye.
We going to miss y'all or something. Y'all,
girl
y'all try to roll
tell you
back
no, because let me tell you something.
You, know,
miss you,
to touch? No.
You have women no. out here.
You miss me.
I don't miss you.
No, you
I
have you miss, have, you have women
you.
Out here.
You may not miss me right now.
No,
it's going to
no.
be a time.
I ain't going to never, never, ever miss you.
When you fold in your t-shirt.
and
it's
going to
cross your mind. Ooh, Dre, I can't call that joker no more, but man. Boy, appreciate it. A folded t-shirt. You hear me?
Yeah, the way I folded them shirts.
You gonna make a picture of Kool-Aid one day.
Yes,
take
right.
a sip. He, boy, you know he should.
Go in there and make me some tacos.
Okay.
That's Jody.
I don't know.
Get in there and make me some tacos.
Y'all be trying it. It's the ego thing with men. Y'all feel like once y'all have touched a woman, that no one else can ever touch her again.
That's right.
And that ain't right.
Look, let me tell you something. No,
I don't know what that's about.
Let me tell you something. And this is one thing. And I think my homeboy, he made a very good point. I had to give him kudos on it. He made this point months ago in a post. He said, men, we can tolerate certain lies from women. I mean, you know, one thing I get tired of is hearing people say, I can't stand a liar. People will lie. It's
yes,
just,
they will.
That's just the fact of life.
All
I don't
day.
Care.
When it, you lie to me, that shows me you care.
That's right.
You yeah, thank you.
Want, you
and see, that's why, that, that's why
yep.
I have a whole issue with the respect thing. Because that's like people saying, well, if you love me, you won't cheat on me. No, people do love each other and still will cheat. Here's the problem.
Mm.
No, I'm just telling you because it's about respecting your relationship.
No, it's not respect. That's about that you is. Being selfish.
Thank
well,
you.
Then, well, you, we can name it whatever you want.
You being selfish.
That's true. We'll take that.
Okay.
But I still love you. Be clear on that.
Okay.
You love me. You just want to love all the other cookies too.
No, I love you.
Hold on. If we get ready, get, don't
what,
you gonna
wait,
start
what,
playing
what,
that
what,
Lenny
what
in there
say,
again.
What do you say? An appetizer and the entree. You just, I'm the entree and you just want your appetizer.
Let me tell you something. You the entree.
You want the order.
You the appetizer and the entree.
And dessert if I feel every like it's in there. There you go. You know,
I like an apple pie.
Peach cobbler.
Boy.
Nana pudding.
This is going
on. I want the I want the hot brownie a la mode.
Well, what's these other guys? They just hors d'oeuvres. They the cocktail hour.
That is.
That's what they are.
Yeah. Okay. y'all gonna get me started.
Some parties you go to, they don't have food. They just have snacks.
They just snacks. Yeah. They little
like
cheese and crackers.
Like finger a meatball, food. You know.
Finger food. I mean, lick my finger.
One of them little,
little meatball on toothpick.
little meatball on toothpick, little cheese.
Well, see, here's the thing. Men, we will tolerate certain lies from women. Oh, I was here, boo, but I was over here. You know, I was out hanging out with these people, but you were hanging out with these other people.
Who does that?
But
I didn't buy but one per. I didn't get but one person.
There you go. Now that's a lie. I'm gonna tell right what? There.
Well,
I'm hiding shoes in the trunk for months.
These shoes, I've had these.
You know what? Ash, I ain't even gonna get into that.
We do it.
But here is the problem. The problem becomes is when a woman lies to a man to sleep with another man. When she does that, she's done. Because men, we territorial, and we don't play that. We'll tell you, hey, I'll let you lie to me and tell me you went to trial on Saturday and you was over at Elevation.
Y'all hear that, ladies? They telling you out the horse's mouth. So what you need to do is quit accepting this mess from them, too.
No,
it's true, because this is the thing. You know what, women, I've heard this. I've heard this argument several times. Mm-hmm. You going to be mad at me because I talked to one little dude for a minute and I'd have forgave you for these 15 women. You've been dogging me out for years. Y'all know y'all heard that, and that's what they're used to. That's what a woman used to justify. There are a lot of women that do that, and
that's her fault. She sat around and stayed for it.
Do you see what I'm saying? See, ladies, y'all just hear that? That's why I'm telling y'all to get
So you want to go even the odds now? So you think that's gonna make us better?
I'm just telling you that's the argument. That's what I'm trying to tell these ladies. You see what Django just said? That's what that man is gonna say to you. So why are you sitting up like Boo Boo the fool for 5 and 10 and 15 years letting somebody dog you out?
Let me tell you something.
And he is not going to give you
just because you was a fool for me don't mean I have to return the favor and be a fool for you.
You right. That's because I ain't no fool for nobody.
Okay, so my thing is
girls, you better get your own. You better get out there and hustle.
No, I'm just going to keep it. I'm going to keep it 200. If you choose to do that, if that's what you choose to do, then there's a saying. You fool me once, shame on you. You fool me twice, shame on me. You fool me three times, the fool is me. So my thing is real simple here. Okay? It's real simple here. If you want to sit around here, you think we going to keep doing it and we going to keep playing this one up in each other. Well, you were sleeping with these women, so I went and slept with your cousin. Okay,
now he can't come to the family.
That's how they get down in the street.
She does enter to the instant realm of thought-bot.
Okay? You can't come to the family reunion. Right. You can't.
You hiding all these dudes that you've been sleeping around with.
But you know what? I will say this.
That's what I'm saying. We need to go get it moving up in here.
There are some people, they live in dysfunctional relationships, and that is what they do. Now, I cheat on you. You cheat on me. I cut you. I left you. Or we back together. Look, there's this girl. I'm not gonna say her name, right? Mm-hmm. On Facebook.
What's her name?
I can't put her out there. Some of y'all may know her. Okay. Her and this guy go back and forth all the time. They just put all their business out, right? Mm-hmm. So they got into a physical altercation. Her face looked awful. Okay. I had never seen a woman's face look this bad. I mean, he tore up. Okay. Because it was crazy. Now, she put a post up the day before talking about, you know, when your dude think you cool, but you really slick crazy. So I guess she tried to go crazy and it didn't work out in her favor. Okay. So she puts up the post of her face and all of this stuff or whatever, and they broke up. Then 2 weeks later, she put up another picture with a ring. I believe in second chances. We can all hello. This is the for a year, right? For a year, this is what they do. So there are just some people. That's how they get down. That's what they like.
I know some folks like that.
Some people. That's just what they do with each other.
Just like to fight.
Well, here's
exceptions to the rule. It's exceptions to every rule.
You know what? And here's the problem with that. And I tell people this, and I put it out there on the poster that people looked at me like I was talking Chinese. You can be honest. The guy said, if you want to go out here and you want to do your thing, be honest with a woman and you will. And I believe that. I believe that at the end of the day, the truth can be paramount to stuff and you can
Let me tell you something. I've met a lot of women in my lifetime that enjoy the truth. I can just tell them.
No, it's fine. Tell them the truth.
That's giving them a decision. You make, listen, baby, you're making a decision.
Right.
That's right.
So,
a month from now, and I don't hear this, we talk about this.
But here's the thing. You have to understand. With honesty, there are also consequences. People think and that's why people don't be honest more, because they don't want the consequences that come with them. Because the consequences could be, if I'm honest with this dude and tell him, hey, look, I'm messing around with this dude, he may not decide to be with me, but I kind of want to be with him. So I'm going to have to let dude number three go so I can just concentrate on dude number one and two. And that's why people are not honest, because they don't want the consequences that come with being
that
honest.
That is true, but you should be honest.
Yeah, you should be honest.
Honest is the best policy. Because
if you're honest in the beginning, it's easier to go on. But if the honesty comes out periodically in the relationship, wait a minute.
Okay.
But
don't assume. Who is this? Who are you?
What I signed up for.
I don't know who this is.
But don't assume, because you're honest with people are going to be honest with you.
Well, that's
you
true.
Will sit around and be honest with people and then mess around. And Joe Blow is over. And you're
well,
like,
look,
wait a minute.
I'm going to say this. There may be whatever for men, but women, we have intuition. Some of us choose to be lied to, and some of us don't. So at the end of the day, mm-hmm. anytime these little girls roll up, I didn't know that was going on. You was a lie. You knew. You just didn't want to know.
Right. You didn't
want to know. You didn't want to know. There are some people that want to be lied to. And there are some people, they looking at you saying, lie to me. I ain't seen you in 3 days. I heard from you, but you told me it's because you busy or because you had to work. Okay, lie to me.
Yeah,
I mean, it's some people that well, men. Like to be
if a man on his game, he ain't gonna lie himself to be lie. You know what? Let's take a
no. It's some men that.
Oh yeah,
we gonna
get you.
Now.
We gonna get you.
No, it's some men that want to be lied.
Nah, ain't no man gonna
be. It's men that want. They got a song about it.
Right.
What was
Mario Winans? He had a little song. He said he don't want to know if you heard me. Keep it on the low.
That boy on the fool.
He sure said it.
I don't want to know. That's what he said.
He sure did.
If you playing me. Keep it on the low.
Hey, and that was a hit.
No, I remember on the down low, because that's when you're going to. But anyway.
Oh, Lord.
Hey, that's Sean Wayans.
We're going to take us another break, and then we're going to come back shortly. And, hey, advocates, if you want to call in, and I want to take a quick minute to shout out to our videographer, D. Editor Woods. He is doing a great job for us. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, and cool photographer too. He ain't made
yeah,
no
low. Cool. Look, he just over there trying to be cool.
Okay, he like, what is really going on?
He like Rain Man. Cool. He just sitting over there chilling. Out. So we want to shout out to him. Don't forget to check him out on My Life, iLife Network on Facebook. He is great. He does great work.
Positive news for people.
Yep. So we'll be back momentarily. We're gonna take us a break and then we'll be back. Ooh. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back with me, Dre, and Ash Cat, Baby Hair. You know, she's
baby hair,
middle of a sandwich in between, like an Oreo cookie.
I got African hair today. I ain't got no baby hair.
You got no baby? Where your baby hair?
It's gone. I got African hair today. I need a hair wash.
You need a hair wash?
Yeah, I got that from the Motherland hair today.
Uh-oh.
I need a hair wash.
Motherland massage oil.
I need a hair wash. I need to wash my hair.
So, advocates, don't forget to shine in on it. Everybody got quiet today.
What's the number? 855-525-5683.
Yeah.
Call in.
Now, you know what you said that with the... with the motivation of a gnat. You got to do it in your sexy voice, bro.
Hey, you know, I'm trying to entice him to call in. Call in and see what's happening.
You
got to
do it sexy. That's how you do it. Go on, do it to him in a sexy voice.
Yeah,
right?
That's so they can hear better, you know.
You can do a Barry White.
Ooh, if I do that, you know, things might change in here.
Okay.
We already been listening to Lenny. You take me too fast.
go on, get to it. Just delay, jump in, sexy voice.
Call on in and, chime in with the devil's advocate. We having us a great time in the building tonight. Is that right, baby?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She said, yeah.
Yeah.
You see how quick that is, fellas? All you got to do is be nice. You got to be a nice guy. Being a nice guy gets you further.
It sure will.
You know, I think every woman should go to Cookie Johnson's class. Magic.
You think so?
Magic's wine. Woo! Cookie the greatest. Do you hear me? The greatest.
She the greatest.
Man, that boy came home with HIV and she never quit smiling.
Hey, that's bad.
I'm trying to tell you. I'm not planning on doing that, but you.
Yeah, thank you. I just. Well, I mean.
I ain't gonna do that.
All right.
She getting paid too, actually.
Boy, listen, why leave and take half or you can stay there and keep it all?
But that's look, let me say this, though. There are a lot of men that they want to say, well, such and such got this many women, or such and such got that, or they came and did this and his woman stayed. But I'm going to be real with you. You're not in the same financial situation as some of these men that you compare yourself to. I'm going to just be real.
Money
makes a lot of people put up with a lot of things.
Man.
But you're not finna be out here cheating and skeeting all over the place and you bringing home $30,000 a year. What you're going to do is have a seat. That's what you're going to do.
You bringing home that much. Anyway, let me chill.
That's what you're going to do. You're going to sit over there in the corner and have a seat.
You know what?
Yeah.
I have a rebuttal to that, but I ain't
gonna. Well, I mean, I'm just saying, look at all the women that fool with celebrity athletes and singers and stuff, and they know they go, oh, well, that's just a part of what comes with the road or that life. Yeah. And they know that they would not be putting up with that if they was messing with a dude that had an average income. But they want that lifestyle. They want that money. They trying to hope you didn't have a prenup so I can go and catch this half real quick after these 10 years.
Shout out to Juanita Jordan.
Okay, y'all dudes better look out. Some of these chicks is on the come up.
Yeah, they on it. But you know,
all of them. Some of them.
I didn't say all.
But some of them. Some. I mean,
there's a vast majority is what we should be saying.
No, trust me. You got some.
Nah. There's a lot of sugar mamas out here, bro, so that don't even work.
Now you cheat.
Well,
she has a point.
Wow.
A lot of girls out here taking care of these men, buying them Jordans and carrying on, and they grown men.
Wow.
I don't want no Jordans.
Oh, wait.
What you want?
I don't want no Jordans.
You want some Hush Puppies?
There we go. I went there with polo boots. I just want to get that.
Yeah, the polo. Y'all hear that, ladies? So if you want to be Dre's sugar mama, you need to show up with a pair of polo boots.
And no fish sandwich.
Then no fish sandwich.
No fish sandwich.
You make me a great hamburger and a pitcher of Kool-Aid, I'll change your life.
Red. It ain't got to be purple.
Yeah, listen, y'all going to think this is a joke, but this is absolute truth. My favorite flavor of Kool-Aid is black cherry.
Okay. That's dark red.
There you go. Black cherry.
You know, black folk, we don't get the flavor. We just say what color. It's red or it's purple.
Don't play.
You know, so you know, let's talk about some trending right quick, because this topic we could go on for over an hour.
You know what? Me, we gonna talk about that in a minute.
Okay.
I like that chicory.
Y'all two over here trying to get
that Kool-Aid, bro.
Oh, y'all just talking about Kool-Aid.
We like invisible Kool-Aid. It's fun. You put it in the refrigerator. Everybody think it's water, and then they drink it.
I used to do that to my kids.
Yeah, it's fun.
Little Dick Gregory ain't never hurt nobody.
That's right.
Anyway, on the trending, folks, what in the world is going on with the Republican debates? I mean, we saw this last week, and I mean, the clown car have gotten really loaded.
It is. It's full. They got about two or three clown cars rolling up in there. Like, I don't even know what to say. I don't know. It's kind of disgraceful, but I will tell you this. What's girl Carly? She sure got Donald Trump together real quick though.
And then Donald Trump is out there playing. Do y'all understand that?
He ain't trying to be.
He don't care nothing about being president.
He's trying to get enough clout.
He's trying to build his brand back up. Yeah, that's all it is.
Donald Trump is a trip.
Yeah,
Donald
but
Trump,
you know
he knows he ain't gonna.
I mean, I was working out last week. And I was at the gym. I said, you know what? I need something because I had kind of gotten slacked off. I was cutting my gym time. I've been normally doing 2.5 hours. I had cut it down to 1 hour and 45 minutes. And I said, you know what? This last 15 pounds I need to lose is going to be hard. So I said, I need something to motivate me. I got in and start doing my treadmill and start watching the Republican debate. And before I knew it, I was at 3 hours. I'm like, what in the world are these dudes talking about? And you know, the funniest question they asked was, who do you think they need to put? Thank you. They need to put them all away. Put on the $10 bill. And the phoniest, I mean.
On the $10 bill.
On the $10 bill.
The $10 bill. You know, they campaign and they finna change it up.
Yeah, they said, who you put? And you know, I think it was Ted Cruz and who else was it? It was someone else said, oh, we need to put Rosa Parks on it.
Don't they know?
Are you serious?
Yeah, Rosa Parks.
I mean, but you got to remember something. These are guys.
They did say that. I couldn't believe that.
When I looked at that, I'm like, is you serious?
What I thought in my head, I was like, that's probably the first black woman that they could think of to come to mind outside of Oprah. Now, I don't know if that's true, but that's how I felt.
They can't deal with Oprah because that was
my initial reaction. It was like Rosa Parks is the first black woman they could think of.
Yeah, yeah.
Outside of Oprah.
If Oprah owned $10, I want $2.5.
But my whole point about it is these are guys who have made their political career, however short it has been, for 3, 4, 5 years. You know, sitting around here talking about anti-immigration. You know, let's get rid of the Mexicans.
That's right. You're supposed to build a wall.
Right. Let's build a wall. Let's electrocute them. Let's deport them. Let's have Minutemen and shoot them. And then you want me to believe that you're going to sit around and put a minority on a $10 bill? I mean, are you serious?
Reaching.
I mean, but it's
reaching with real short arms.
No, because here's the thing. Now, I also have as much disgruntled conduit dissonance. Cognitive dissonance for the black folks I saw sitting in the audience. I mean, the RNC really had to go and dig some of these crispy, crunchy, crackety anyway up to sit them in
there
and sprinkle them
really
in there.
No, they really don't. It's a lot of us. They have a disdain for us. There are a lot of other black people that I've met before that they feel like I'm gonna be quite frank with this. They feel more like white is right, and they want to align with anyone white and anything that white people.
You see them on Fox News.
Yeah,
anything Stacey that Dash.
Yeah,
quite a few others.
Yeah, it's a few of them. So
Donna Borelli and
yeah,
all the
rest. I don't think they had to dig that hard. You got a lot of them.
I'm just saying. But you know, when they do the debate, they try to make it look. Yeah. Somewhat
mixed.
But I mean, it wasn't really mixed. It was like 99.1%. You know, they got a couple of us sprinkled up in there. And I mean, they're doing that because they know that the debates are a joke right now. It hadn't even been primary. So they know black folks are just listening in to get the giggles. So what they do is they sit down and say, oh my God, did they say Rosa Parks? Oh, well, maybe I need to pay attention now.
Yeah, it's great.
They wouldn't.
Well, I treat the debates like I do baseball. I don't start watching till the playoffs.
Right.
These folks just going, I don't even look at these clowns. I wait till we at the last couple, then I start paying attention. But right now, these guys.
See, I like to pay attention to the debates, though, because as asinine as a lot of these thoughts and comments are, there's a large population of people that agree with these folks.
That's the nuts.
And but you got to know what they're thinking or how they're feeling. So I like to tune in. Like, I was amazed with some of the outlandish things that Donald Trump would say and then how much support he would get behind it, because there are people that really feel that way. I wish I could remember the name of the caster. It was after a debate. Mm-hmm. And there was a newscaster. He's a Latino, and he was interviewing the white guy, and he was telling him, your people don't even belong here. You need to get out of here. Go back to your country. Blah blah blah. All of this on camera. And so I think that people, even though it's hilarious to us and it's funny to us, there's a good segment of the population that believe these things that they are saying, and they agree with them. Trump. And if they could enforce them, they would.
Yeah, that's called the knucklehead minority. I'm like, you know, and let me tell you something. You have 33%.
Don't even know what that is.
Yeah, the youngsters, they don't even know what that is. But we leave that there. You have 33% of registered voters that are complete and utter nuts. They nuts. They either, and most of them, the really bad ones, are usually extreme right. And I mean, they believe Obama's a Muslim. He didn't go to school here. He wasn't born here. You know, I mean, you still got people after 7.5 years of this man being in office still talking about he a Muslim. I mean, that's the way they think.
But I will say this. They're crazy, but they're crazy like foxes, because then you have a large proportion of our population that won't even get out and vote or go to the midterm.
Yeah,
I go out and vote.
That's
Everybody
right. I vote too.
Vote.
You
I
need to vote. Y'all know how I feel about voting.
I talk too crazy not to vote.
Yeah, yeah. That's what we got to do. And black folks, please.
Really, you need to vote in the basic.
There
right.
You go.
In your local election.
In the local election. That's what makes the immediate difference.
Right. Because Arkansas, I hope you see what you have gotten yourself into.
Boy,
after last year.
Play.
So now when you
ain't that embarrassing every time you see this fool on the world news, I'm just like, God dang it. That's what people are thinking about all our kids.
Well, you know what they say.
I don't know, Bill, you know the running joke.
The rolling joke is in Arkansas, thank God for Mississippi. Because if it wasn't for Mississippi, we'd be in last place. So my thing about it is, you know what, let's take us one more break. And then we're going to come back in a minute. And we're going to go it in. Again, if you want to call us, talk to us. 855-525-5683. Y'all call us in. We'll be back. Devil's Advocate. Django. All right, folks, we are back here at the Devil's Advocate. And boy, this has been
something
interesting today. I mean, Dre, you done came up and
hey, listen,
you done did Showtime at the Apollo.
She wasn't here when we talked about the difference in men and women. Remember what we were talking about that earlier before she got in?
Yeah.
We need a woman's perspective.
That's why we need a woman's perspective.
You right on time.
Right on time.
No.
I was explaining that the reason men get so devastated about cheating. Men are physical. Women are physical. If a woman cheats, that man that she cheats with, he tapped into something far more than physical.
Oh, he tapped into something already. I said that before.
Yeah.
And it probably was
that's
already
why I said
there.
That again.
So yeah, it probably was already there.
Now, that's true, though.
That's true.
That's
men
true.
Are absolute,
we're emotional. We're emotional.
Exactly.
And mental. And so a lot of times to get us to the bed, we already, you know, you got something going on in our mind or something that
go.
We like about you. Or some type of connection we feel. Now, this is not true now, but you got this new breed.
Well, I mean,
you got this new breed of thoughts. It don't
take much.
Yeah, it don't. They just going. They just doing what they do. But a real lady, as far as if you had a woman and she's been with you and she's been faithful to you for years and then she goes out, it's definitely on a deeper level if she's with some other guy. It's true. And then men, I mean, y'all are hit a hole in the wall.
Well, see,
and don't even care.
Don't
y'all seen women and then never speak to the woman again. Can't remember her name. Don't know what she looked like.
Yeah, who was you again?
I've seen me and tell women before. Like, I don't know you.
Hey, well, I don't do that.
I haven't seen it.
No, you might have to go back.
I mean,
don't do that.
I may not remember her name,
but I remember the back of her.
Her name immediately becomes Lil Mama. No, I know
right.
you.
I've seen guys too tell girls like, "Well, you knew what it was." They don't care.
Yeah, and you got women out here running off of that same playbook. Listen,
they do, but women, you need to remember you're a woman and not a man at the end of the day.
So we're not built.
The same, and no matter what lie society has told you to make you think that their behavior is okay, it's really not.
Right. Thank you.
It's really
Preach.
Not. You're causing havoc to your own.
We got us a phone call.
Hello, this is Django Stock Bot Service. I'm giving a 2-for-1 special on cheating. Go ahead.
Man, my bad, man. I was riding the train and couldn't get off the train.
Boy, here you go. What my high blood pressure medicine? What's up, Stanley? Ladies and gentlemen, this is Stanley calling us in. What's going on, boy? You got to make it quick. You called us late today. I guess you must have been caught up with
the
tacos.
Train just stopped, doctor. They wouldn't even let me get off. I'm sorry.
What's going on, bro?
Me, man. I couldn't get no reception on the train. Tell me what y'all talking about. Give me something quick.
Okay. What we're talking about is that when a man cheats, they expect women to get over it. But when a woman cheats, a man is devastated. Do you believe that?
Women ain't got no business cheating.
Well, preach. No.
No, gosh. No, sorry.
There you go.
No, sorry.
Well, do you think it's an issue that here was somebody, and this is why the topic got hot, because somebody tried to allege, a guy tried to allege that if a woman cheats on a man because she don't respect him. I said, no, I think it's because she don't respect the relationship or she don't respect herself.
It could be a variety of things. I think that.
Or it could be she just fed up.
Something to do with.
Let her go.
I mean, it's something. She's some kind of gap she's trying to close on that. A dude's going to cheat just for the simple fact that we love to hunt.
Mm-hmm.
So as long as we feel like we still got it, we're going to keep doing our thing.
Mm-hmm.
That in turn causes a woman to cheat when she feels like we not taking care of business at home, for lack of a better word.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, unless you run to the thought bot, and then they just cheat.
They just do it because they do
can.
It. That's just what they do.
Yeah, but you know what that is when you meet them.
Yeah.
You know what they are.
Yeah.
I mean, you know what it is.
Yeah, you know what it is. Well, you saw me there. You in hiding.
Yeah, man, I'm actually like in the train station with folks sitting around me, so I'm trying to be like cordial and look like I'm on a business card. I don't want people to
come. Black folks at corporate jobs.
Yeah, give me something else. I can talk about you because I'm a lawyer.
Okay, well, you know what? Let's get you. See, we got the music chiming in. Stanley, we're going to hit you back next week, bro. But I appreciate you calling us in.
Because I'm in love.
Boss, sit down.
Aww, he's so sweet.
Bye, Stanley. We'll hit you next week,
bro. Shout out to Stanley and his wife.
There you go. He in love. He loved her.
He better love her.
Yeah. Well, folks, thank you again for coming in. They just leave it to Stanley. Then when he do call, he call in like 3-4 minutes before this over. But you know what? We always appreciate my boy calling in. He always got some good stuff for us. You know what, folks? We're going to go ahead and shut this one down. Again, look forward for our Ask the Attorney segment that's coming up within the next week or so. And we thank you again for joining us here on the Devil's Advocate.
Y'all get that child support right.
No. That's right. Get it right. Jody, Tommy, get it right. So we're going to go ahead in this one. We want to thank you guys. Hey, our Instagram page will be up this week, and y'all get ready to go and shine that up. And we got some other things going on. I'm finalizing the speed date night. We're moving the location. Ooh. So everybody, thank you for joining us.
Y'all bring Dre them polos.
There you go. Thank you for joining us today. Of course, look us up Facebook, look us up on Instagram. We'll see you guys again here next week, same bat time, same bat channel. And remember, if you can't stand the heat, stay out of Hell's Kitchen. Bye, folks.